I've spent the majority of my career around rowing machines, specifically Concept 2 and other machines as well. But over that time, I've developed a really strong toolbox of accessories that I feel just maximize my experience whenever I'm on it. So if you're looking to maximize your experience on your machine and you want to know the best accessories to consider in 2020, stay tuned. That's what we're going to get right into. It's taken years for me to actually sort out what accessories I like and don't like to have when I'm on this machine. And it's constantly evolving, as well as I get a lot of feedback from the Dark Horse community. What works? What do they like? What don't they like? And so today you're gonna benefit from all of that information wrapped into one nice, neat little bundle. If this is your first time here, welcome. I'm Shane Farmer, and this is Dark Horse Rowing, where you build the life that you wanna build, and we just happen to use rowing, generally, to help you get there. Okay, for the breakdown today, number one, all of these products are gonna be listed in the description below, so make sure you go down there to check them out when you're interested in looking at any of them. With that being said, I'm gonna break my suggestions into three main categories: accessories for the machine, tech for yourself, and then equipment and clothing, as in like the things that you want on your person. And then at the end, stay tuned because I've got a bonus suggestion. Yes, I went over 10, I always do, but you know, saying the top 12 just didn't sound right. So 10 with bonus at the end. Okay, as far as machine accessories go, the number one thing that I'm going to suggest to you is a phone mount. And for that, I am loving the Vapor Fitness phone mount. It's something that has been on all of my machines. It moves between my ski erg, my bike erg, my row erg, and it just fits perfectly. It snugly holds your phone. It's silicone. It matches in color to the machine. They have them in black and green, both Concept 2 colors. So it fits perfectly. I love this thing. If you watch our videos, you've seen it before, but this thing is just an invaluable tool that will hold your phone, do what it needs to do, stay out of the way. And it's just a really perfect fit for the machine. I just love this thing. It's the best phone holder that I've found for this machine. So I highly encourage you. That is just accessory number one that you should think about for the machine. Accessory number two for the machine itself is going to be a seat pad. Many people find that as they begin to put in meters, especially as the meters get longer and longer and longer, your butt starts to hurt and it gets a little bit uncomfortable rocking back and forth on that seat. And from beginners all the way up to high level rowers, use seat pads as a way to just make the row more comfortable. Now, there are a variety of seat pads out there. My suggestion is the Hornet Water Sports gel pad. There are others, again, very like thick memory foam pads. The problem with those is that they elevate you so much that it actually changes the physiological approach to the stroke on the machine. So I'm not an advocate. Check out the Hornet Water Sports. It's a beautiful gel pad. It sits low. It just gives you enough cushion to support you so that as your distances increase, as you get more butt in seat time, it's gonna help alleviate those aches and pains that come with just rocking back and forth on the same point over and over and over. And you find that a pad like this is going to just make the experience a little bit more comfortable. It's not overly expensive and comes in at a price range where it's kind of easy to just say, yeah, I'd like to add a little bit more comfort to my experience. Okay, now we're going to get into the tech accessories that can really enhance the experience that you have with the machine. Tech piece number one that you're probably going to find very, very helpful as you get into this machine is a heart rate monitor. Believe me, there are a lot of heart rate monitors to choose from. My personal favorite is the Polar H10. A lot of different heart rate monitors are able to connect with the machine or able to just sit on your body like a watch type. The Polar H10 has probably the most positive review background from people who have been using this machine for a long time. It's tried, it's tested. Garmin is another brand that's out there, but people just generally gravitate to that Polar H10 heart rate monitor. It's reasonable in price. It's a wise investment because it's gonna connect directly to the monitor. It's going to give you heart rate feedback as you go through your workouts, which means that you can track through heart rate zones and make sure that if you like heart rate training, or if you just want to gain a better understanding of what your heart rate is doing, perhaps if you're some kind of a cardiac patient, it's going to help you understand what's happening with your heart as your workout progresses, as well as helping you to understand where exactly you are in the progression of that workout as far as your cardiovascular performance. Next up, the watch. So many people ask about what watch I'm wearing in the videos that I felt, you know what, you guys should actually know. I think I often answer in the comments, but let's just get it out there. The watch that I love that I am using currently is the Garmin Fenix 5X Plus, recently updated to the 6X Plus Sapphire. It's a great, great smartwatch, especially for activity. It does a fantastic job on almost all levels except gathering heart rate while you're rowing. For some reason, it really struggles with that, which is why I suggested a separate heart rate monitor, but that's pretty uniform across all watch heart rate monitors. They're just not perfect yet when it comes to gathering heart rate during activity. So that aside, it is an amazing watch. You can program so many different activities. It has GPS, it has an altimeter, it has a barometer, I think. For example, if I wanna go for an 8-mile run, I can tell the watch, program an 8-mile run for me. Oh, and by the way, I only want to go north for that run. It'll set an 8-mile route using local GPS to determine the best route and loop that brings me 4 miles away, 4 miles back to home where I started. Those features make it an excellent watch and I really recommend it. Just a note though, it is definitely a larger watch on your wrist. So as long as you like that, you're good to go. Next up, the audio. In a lot of my follow along videos, you've seen I'm always slipping my audio in. If you want to make the experience of watching our videos or listening to music a little bit more intimate while you're on the machine, perhaps you live in an apartment and so it's not possible for you to blare music. I'm in my garage. It's okay, nobody here cares. But if you're somewhere where you need to keep the music down a little bit, I highly suggest AirPods. I didn't get them for the longest time. I finally tried them out and man, I love them. They are so simple. I just put them in. I never worry about them falling out and normally that's a problem for me. Earbuds have never liked to stay in my ears, but these, I've never had an issue. I pop them in, the music starts or I'm watching the video and I get crystal clear music. If you really want to, you can upgrade to those pros so that you get noise canceling as well. And that's gonna create a really intimate experience for you. So if audio is something that you wanna create a more intimate experience, which I generally enjoy when I'm on the machine, do consider checking out some AirPods or similar earbuds. Last up on the tech side, for those of you who enjoy getting footage of yourself to perhaps critique and coach yourself, the camera that I use here that's the best, easiest, it's such a simple machine and I absolutely love it because it can film in 4K, it's beautiful, you can also do widescreen, is the DJI Action Cam. It's a really small action cam. I'm gonna suggest this bundle because it comes with so many different accessories. You can mount it, you can do whatever you want. You can track your monitor if you wanna film your monitor. You can put it on the ground next to you so that it's filming you from a profile so that afterwards you can go and review your own technique, which is something I highly encourage you to do. Too many people don't do that. They just row and want somebody to tell them what they're doing wrong if they give them numbers, but it's much easier to be able to analyze your technique and your stroke to improve if you've seen yourself doing it. So I highly encourage you, check out the DJI Action Cam. It's what I use here whenever we're doing any kind of action cam stuff because you can shake it and it's got really great internal stabilization. So if you're running with it, if you want somebody to be filming you as you're doing it so that you can, again, review, it's a fantastic tool for that and comes in at a very reasonable price point as far as action cameras go. All right, moving into the apparel side of things. Number one, first and foremost, and this may be a shift for you, compression shorts. Nothing other than compression shorts, except for my other recommendation. But why do I say compression shorts? It's generally the accepted uniform of rowers globally, men and women alike. You want a compression short because you don't want any extra fabric potentially getting caught in the wheels of the machine, as well as you don't want any extra fabric getting bunched up underneath you while you're sitting on the machine because that will get very uncomfortable and can potentially create some sore spots over time if you end up doing a lot of that. So I highly encourage compression shorts like the 3-pack of Nelius compression shorts that I've found here. They're inexpensive. It's a great way to go as a general uniform. They come in lots of colors. Now, my other suggestion is the Lululemon Pacebreaker 7-inch. I just love this short. I own tons of them. And it's generally what I wear most of the time if I'm not in competition. If I'm competing, I'm wearing a compression short. But if I'm just training at home, I'm often gonna wear that Pacebreaker because it has a lined inside, which means that I can take that short, I can work out, and then I can just go out into the world. And I'm not wearing compression shorts out into the regular world. And so my two preferences are either the compression short or the Lululemon Pacebreaker 7-inch. Next on the clothing side, shoes. So many of you guys ask what shoes I wear. I am a huge fan of Innovate, INOV-8. As a company, I've been wearing them forever. They're just fantastic shoes, and they're perfect because they're minimal, they're thin, but they're not barefoot. I can't get behind the full barefoot thing, and I'm not knocking it. That's just not me. So my personal preference on accessory is going to be something like the Innovate F-Lite 230, which is a very nice, simple shoe without a whole lot of cushion. That means you're going to get direct contact to the machine. Or if you want to go the route, because it is acceptable as well, to wear a weightlifting shoe. Innovate also makes a weightlifting shoe that has a boa strap, which I really like. It just snugs down really easy with a little spin buckle. And that is fantastic because it gives you solid connection and a different wedge or angle of approach at that ankle. So for some people who have ankle mobility issues, the lifters can also be a good way of improving their mobility on the machine. Next up, and this is one I just always recommend and you'll always see me in, is a good hat on the machine, or a sweatband or a visor, something to keep the sweat out of your eyes. There's nothing worse than being in the middle of a piece and having to let go with one hand and wipe your face while trying to maintain your splits. It's the worst. You will almost always see me in a hat on the machine. If I'm on there for any period of time, I'm in a hat almost every time because it's just a sweat collection device for me. So for those, I'm just gonna suggest Dark Horse hats, because we sell a couple of them. Go check them out on our website. Again, the description is below, but we offer some hats. You can buy whatever hat you like, but I just love having a hat on because it just helps with the sweat collection. I don't have to think about it, and I'm never wiping my eyes in the middle of a workout, you know, with that stinging eye sweat. Nobody likes that. Just avoid it. Give yourself some kind of sweat hat collection device. And finally, on this side is going to be a simple water bottle. Stay hydrated during your workouts. That is extremely important. Now, there are a few factors you can consider in a water bottle, and I'll explain what I like and why. I prefer, one, a bottle where you can just pop the top, kind of like your traditional bicycling water bottle, that I can then, and then that's soft so that I can squeeze it to get water out if I need to, so that I don't have to fidget with unscrewing a cap or sucking through a straw or anything like that. I want one that I can squeeze to get the liquid out. The other is making sure that if you like, for example, cold water or room temp water, that it's gonna stay the same temperature throughout your workout, especially if you're working out in the summer and you're outside, or you don't want temperature to be adjusting the temperature of your water. So that's why I like something like the Polar insulated water bottle, is because it has all of those features. It's inexpensive. You just pop it right down next to you on the ground and there you go. That's all you really need, a good solid water bottle you can depend on that covers the features that you need so that you can continue to take in liquid throughout your workout. Oh, and it's time for the bonus section. That was 10, but now come the bonus. And all of these bonuses are gonna fall under the category of cleaning and maintenance. Just three tools that I think are extremely valuable when it comes to taking regular care and maintenance of your machines, and they're very simple. I would just encourage you to have these around in some format or another. Number one of these is going to be 3-in-1 oil. That's what Concept 2 recommends for cleaning the chains on your machine. It's just simple. You do it once a month maybe, and you're gonna do that with a lint-free microfiber cloth so that you don't get any other junk on the chain as you're cleaning it. The only thing you need to do with this is just make sure that you pull the chain or the handle all the way out slowly and gently. Perhaps one person holds it back there while the other person puts a little bit of 3-in-1 oil on the rag, not soaking wet, just enough to wipe down the chain all the way front to back, and then run it through with maybe 10 to 20 good hard strokes after you're done. So the two products there are going to be that 3-in-1 oil. You can obviously get Concept 2 chain oil, but it's all the same thing. So 3-in-1 oil is great, and then some microfiber cloths so that you're not gonna get any junk onto the chain that you're gonna clean. And number three of these products is a great vacuum to have nearby. Now, if you have a vacuum at home, fantastic. I'm just a big fan of this Black & Decker Dust Buster because it's quick, it's handy, it's black, so it matches the machine, which I think is great. If you couldn't tell, I like the whole matching colors thing. And this sits right next to your machine. It's handheld, it's easy, it's much more quiet. I use a shop vac here in my garage, but something like this is just so convenient for you to make sure that you're vacuuming the flywheel, the side of the flywheel on the damper face, that you're vacuuming all the little nooks and crannies so that the machine stays clean and dust-free, because it is important that over time you don't allow dust to start collecting on these machines, especially especially in the flywheel where it begins to have an impact on drag factor and damper setting, all things that we can just avoid if we can just give it regular vacuums and wipe downs. These accessories can go a long ways towards improving your feel, your engagement, your fun factor on these machines. Pick the ones that start to work for you and discard those that don't. And again, over time, test more and more to see what you prefer. And in the comments below, tell me what you already use and what you're thinking about trying. And just a reminder again, all of these are in the description below so you can find those products directly. Let me know what you think. I'm curious what accessories you guys are using and what you're thinking about trying for yourself. If you enjoyed learning about these accessories and you're getting into the rowing machine, make sure that you subscribe so that you get alerted whenever we come out with new videos. And then below, check out our playlist of the best videos from 2019 to help you get started on this machine.